I've asked my spouse 100 times to care about my needs. I've told him my love language. I've told him how I feel loved the most. He just gets attacked. He dismisses me. He invalidates me and he demeans me. I've asked my spouse 100 times to care about my needs. These are the comments I read every day. I've told my husband over and over and over again what I need from him. I've set the bar so low and he still trips over it. I've told him my love language. I've had calm talks with him, asking him to prioritize this or that, and he won't. First of all, I'm sorry. If I were you, I would be furious. I would be scared and feel alone. If I were you, I'd be building up bitterness and resentment, just like you are. If I were you, I would probably create some narratives in my head about how he doesn't love me. If I were you, I'd be trying anything to be heard and validated. Calmness and quiet hasn't worked. So let's try criticism and getting loud. I mean, I shouldn't have to spoon feed him, right? I shouldn't have to treat him like a widow baby because his widow baby brain didn't get it the first time around. So now I need to use my big girl voice, right? The only problem, that's called contempt. And it destroys marriages just as much as his avoidance does. Yes, he's neglecting you. Yes, you've asked him 100 times. Yes, it's infuriating. My only question, how long are you planning on staying in a relationship where someone only neglects you? I mean, have you ever asked yourself that? Maybe that's why you've been here for so long, because you never did. What are you doing to protect your heart from emotional abuse? Because no one can answer those questions for you. Only you can. Yes, he needs to treat you better, and I'm doing everything I can to get him to treat you better. But you're the first person who needs to understand your value. You're the first person who needs to understand your self-worth. No one can do that for you. It's always going to be easier to blame them. It's much harder to ask, why is it so hard for me to stay in a relationship where I feel neglected? I mean, it should be easy to leave that type of relationship, but it's not, is it? You can ask, you can demand, you can get loud, you can stay calm, you can criticize, you can people-please, you can sacrifice and give, you can develop resentment, but you can't make someone else care about your needs, wants, and desires, can you? And I'm not saying go get a divorce tomorrow. That's not always the answer. I'm saying stop letting years go by while the bitterness and resentment only build. I'm saying change the dynamic before you hate him, because you will always be labeled as too much to an emotionally unavailable person. Stop pretending that it's sustainable to stay in a relationship where there's no trust, there's no friendship, there's no intimacy or closeness. You're not on the same team. You can't rely on them emotionally. That's not sustainable. You deserve kindness and consideration and respect and reciprocation and curiosity and understanding and selflessness. But you have to make sure you're advocating for yourself and your relationship at the first signs of being neglected of those. Because I know where the path leads when you don't. Do you? Because healing can take place. I'm absolutely a product of that. When you have to sit in front of a counselor and both talk about your feelings and fears and triggers and traumas and why you react the way you do, you finally start listening to each other and hearing each other and not feeling attacked or not feeling a need for criticism. You can both become vulnerable with each other, and that's where healing takes place. It's possible, but you have to demand that.